Here's the first problem that we took a look at in class today, and I promised people that I would make the video so that you could see the solution to the problem. The first part of the question, a reminder, first of all, that the questions that I give you on the test will be broken into smaller parts. So don't worry about it being as kind of vague as part B is here. I'll give you separate steps for each part. First component of this problem is balancing the equation, and just to reiterate, when you see that you have a situation where you need to balance the equation, you want to make sure you understand that you're putting coefficients in front and that each coefficient represents a number of moles. So for this particular problem, and I think most people had little trouble balancing this, we see that it's 1 mole of the propane, 5 moles of the oxygen gas, 3 moles of the carbon dioxide, and 4 moles of the water. Now, from this point forward, we can kind of ignore the carbon dioxide and the water. They're not a part of this question. If you notice that when we read the question, it says, what volume of oxygen gas, that's this particular reactant, would be used or is needed for the complete combustion of 5.53 grams of propane? So perhaps the first thing that we need to do is figure out what volume, since we're talking about a gas, we need to remind ourselves that volume is often the means by which a gas is measured. So perhaps the first question we need to answer here is what volume of oxygen gas would be necessary to react with our 5.53 grams of propane, this first reactant right here. So let's take a look at that. Let's do the stoichiometry. If you see a balanced equation, then you have to assume that it's stoichiometry. So let's set up that stoichiometry problem here, starting with our 5.53 grams of propane. And as I've mentioned many times in the past, it's an excellent idea to write down not only the unit, but also the substance. Make your stoichiometry grid, and one step at a time, try to resolve what is necessary in order to solve this particular problem. So we recall from way back when we learned how to do stoichiometry, and even prior to that, that we can convert grams of a substance to number of moles of a substance by using the molar mass. So 1 mole of propane, which, as you calculate on a separate problem, has a molar mass of 44.1 grams. And again, let's write the formula for the unit, for the substance, so that we can illustrate that we're canceling not only mass, in this case, or the unit, but also the substance. Now we have moles of propane, but we're trying to figure out how many liters of gas would be produced. So at this point, we take advantage of the mole ratio. And that will give us our 5 moles of oxygen, which we're getting from the balanced equation, and our 1 mole of the propane, again, from the balanced equation. The reason we balance the equation is so we could utilize this mole ratio. So moles of propane now divides out. And we have moles of oxygen, but we'd like to have liters of oxygen. And here's a very important step. Let's assume that we're dealing with conditions at STP, standard temperature and pressure. That means that 22.4 liters of this gas, and in fact any gas, would occupy or would have a quantity of 1 mole. So moles of oxygen divides out. We're left with liters of oxygen. We're ready to calculate our final answer, and the response that your calculator would give is 14.0 liters of oxygen. That's the quantity of gas at STP. So right here, I've included P1, V1, and T1 for conditions at STP. Standard pressure, 101.3 kPa, the volume that I calculated, 14.0 liters, and standard temperature, 273 K. And right here we have our new conditions as stated in the problem. 105 kPa, which is 1.04 atmospheres converted to kPa. X is our volume, unknown volume, what volume is being asked in the question. And 298 K, which is our 25 degrees Celsius converted to proper metric term, which is Kelvin. And lastly, we decide that we're going to have to use the combined gas law. Our unknown value is V, so we solve for V, plug our number.